I'm going to tell you a little about dynamometers, and they look like this. And what you have got is spring up here, so when you pull here you will elongate this spring and get more and more force. And here you have a scale, and you can see how much force is that is pulled here. This scale will normally be in Newton, and this one is up to 20 Newton. It is so that I think you might have seen this in school. They are sold for schools and in many kinds, and therefore they are quite cheap to buy. This dynamometer has helped me a lot in my sewing, but I know that a lot of skilled people sewing have not used them, so it's not like I say you need to have them. Now I'll show you how to measure the upper thread tension with this dynamometer and put a loop on here. I'll put it on this dynamometer and then remember to lower the presser foot, and then you start to pull here in the dynamometer. And while you pull, you measure, and it will vary a little, but you take the mean value. Then you can set another setting and measure again, and in this way you will find out how much each setting here will make in force on the thread. You have to be aware that up at maximum thread tension, you can have a problem that spring in here is squeezed to the bottom, and therefore the thread tension becomes very unstable. And you shouldn't use the machines if that's the case. So you have to lower the thread tension a little to avoid that. If you want a higher thread tension, you can get heavier springs to put into this case, this tension case, and in this way you can get higher thread tension. You have to be aware that different kind of threads will make different kind of tension here. So you have to measure it for every kind of thread you use. These dynamometers is cheap. I would buy three of them. One with a max of 1 Newton, one with a max of 10 Newton, and one with a max of 50 Newton. In this way you will be able to measure all kind of things. And things you can measure is lower thread tension, upper thread tension, force on presser foot, and traction of feed dogs. That's kind of things that can be good to measure. Okay? If you have got a simple kitchen digital scale, then you have an easy way to check your dynamometer like this, and to pull up to the ceiling and see what the weight loss would be.